on two specific days of the year, October 22nd and February 22nd, an extraordinary phenomenon occurs at the great temple of Abu Simbel. The sun rises and unusually penetrates deep into the temple until it reaches the sanctuary housing four statues. The sunlight illuminates the face of the statue of Ramses II along with the gods Ra-Horakhty and Amun, while the fourth god Ptah remains in darkness. This phenomenon lasts for more than 20 minutes before the sun gradually recedes, marking the end of this unique astronomical event. But why does this phenomenon occur, and what is its explanation? This is what we will uncover in this video. So, let's start from the beginning. Firstly, why did Ramses II build the Abu Simbel temples? Contrary to popular belief, Abu Simbel is not just one temple, but two: the Great Temple and the Small Temple. The Great Temple is dedicated to King Ramses II, with its main deity being Ra-Horakhty, while the Small Temple is dedicated to his wife and the love of his life, Nefertari, alongside the goddess Hathor. The philosophy behind building the temples represents the areas embodying the spirit of the god Horus, associated with the region of Maha, and the spirit of the goddess Hathor, the lady of the region of Ibshek. These are the local names of the areas surrounding the ancient Abu Simbel temples before they were relocated in the 60s during the construction of the High Dam. The facade of the Great Temple is adorned with four statues of King Ramses II, with a statue carved above the entrance representing the god Ra-Horakhty, the temple's principal deity. Interestingly, the third statue from the right was damaged in an earthquake during Ramses' reign, and the ancient Egyptians were unable to repair it, leaving it as it was. Inside the sanctuary where the phenomenon occurs, we find statues of the great gods of ancient Egypt with Ramses among them. From right to left, there is the god Ra-Horakhty, the chief of the Ennead of Heliopolis. Next to him is Ramses II, followed by the god Amun, the lord of Thebes and ruler of the Egyptian Empire, and finally the god Ptah, the lord of Memphis and the god of craftsmen in ancient Egypt. On the facade of the small temple, we find statues of Ramses and his wife Nefertari standing side by side. The inscriptions on the temple's entrance state that it is dedicated to the great royal wife, Nefertari, and then describe her as the one for whom Ra rises. The sun rises for her. The small temple represents the eternal embodiment of the love story between Ramses II and his beloved Nefertari, whom he first met when he was still a young boy, around 14 years old, when his father, King Seti I, introduced her to him. However, fate had it that Nefertari passed away before she could witness the opening of the temple with her own eyes, leaving Ramses to face life alone after spending so many years by his side. Even in her afterlife, Ramses gave her the greatest gift, tomb number 66 in the Valley of the Queens, which became Nefertari's final resting place. This tomb is considered one of the greatest masterpieces crafted by the artists and artisans of ancient Egypt, if not the greatest of all. Thirdly, how did scientists discover the solar alignment phenomenon at Abu Simbel? In 1873, the Abu Simbel temples had an extraordinary visitor, the British novelist Amelia Edwards. During her visit to the site, she observed a strange phenomenon that no one had noticed before. On a specific day, the sun changed its usual path. Instead of rising as usual and not entering the temple, the sun's rays penetrated the halls of the temple until they reached the sanctuary, illuminating the face of Ramses's statue within. In 1877, Edwards published a book titled A Thousand Miles Up the Nile, in which she described this phenomenon. The book became immensely popular at the time and was her most successful work. With this phenomenon recorded, Egyptologists began to pay attention to other temples in Egypt, discovering that many of them featured astronomical alignments based on similar architectural principles as Abu Simbel. This discovery reshaped the world's understanding of Egyptology and the greatness of ancient Egyptian civilization. Fourthly, when does the solar alignment phenomenon on Ramses' face occur? The solar alignment on Ramses' face occurs at sunrise on October 21st and February 21st each year. Initially, both scientists and the public were puzzled by this phenomenon, as it was clear that the ancient Egyptians did not leave anything to chance, and this alignment was a deliberate architectural design with 100% precision. When the temple was relocated from its original site in 1964 during the construction of the Aswan High Dam, the phenomenon was delayed by one day due to the temple's new location, now occurring on February 22nd and October 22nd, a day later than before. Some interpretations suggest that this phenomenon is related to the dates of Ramses' birth and ascension to the throne, while others propose that it marks the deification of Ramses himself. These explanations faced significant challenges, as we know, for example, that Ramses II's coronation took place sometime in June, and his exact birth date remains unknown. In fact, we have no records of birth dates from ancient Egypt to precisely determine when anyone was born. Therefore, these interpretations are unlikely, despite their continued repetition to this day. Perhaps their poetic nature, even if untrue, still captivates the public's imagination. Fifthly, what is the explanation of this phenomenon? As scientific research advanced, the most plausible and convincing explanation for this phenomenon emerged. This explanation partially aligns with the nature of Egyptian civilization, which was built on agriculture in a society dominated by farmers. The ancient Egyptians divided the year into three seasons: Akhet, the flood season, Heret, winter, and Shemu, the harvest season. The dates of October 21st and February 21st mark the beginning of the Pere and Shemu seasons. Since the temple is located in the far south, more than 1,000 kilometers away from the capital at the time, Pyramesses, now in the Sharqiya Governorate, and even 500 kilometers south of Luxor, the farmers in this region needed an important event to remind them of the dates for planting and harvesting. This ensured that offerings in the temple would be made regularly, providing economic benefits. It was also part of the Egyptian state's control over the region and a clear message to areas beyond the southern borders. In the end, this phenomenon clearly shows that the ancient Egyptians left no room for chance when it came to science and planning. Everything they built carries a profound meaning and message, inviting us to explore and reflect on the legacy of the ancient Egyptians. This message was embraced and executed by those in charge of relocating the temple in the 60s, with the help of over 2,000 Egyptian workers who achieved another miracle by moving the temple while preserving this unique phenomenon. This demonstrates to the world that the genes of their ancestors still live on among them, and their loyalty to a great king like Ramses continues to resonate in their hearts. Thank you for joining us on this journey through history. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more fascinating insights into ancient Egypt and its wonders. Until next time.